Hello everybody, I'm Betsy Romero from Hatari Labs, and in this tutorial I will show you how to insert a background image in ModelMuse. It is very common that before we start doing the modeling in ModelMuse, we first start with a geographic information system like QGIS, where we can see our data and define the information we are going to import into ModelMuse. We usually use background images for a better understanding of where we are located and what we are seeing and how this terrain may be affecting our results. And it is also useful to have a background image in ModelMuse as we do in QGIS. So to do this, I have QGIS open and I will go to Plugins and Manage and Install Plugins. Here, as it is here, I need to put in the search bar Open Layers plugin, which is the one that it's here. It will show up here for you, Open Layers plugin. And this plugin will let us add layers like Google Maps layers, Bing Maps, or OpenStreetMap, which we can overlap with our shape files. So now I go here and click on Install Plugin. Okay, now it says the plugin is installed successfully. Now I exit here and I'm going to import some shape files I have, which are defined in my modeling area, and they are also wells that I want to model in ModelMuse. So first I will add the vector layer. I have here my study area. And also here, my wells. Okay, here they are. Now, I will go here to this web tab and select Open Layers plugin. And here I can choose which is the layer I want to activate. In this case, I will first try with maybe Google Physical. And here you can see, this is the Google Physical layer, and I can move it here. And here it is. Oops, I will zoom to layer. Okay. I will zoom to this layer and activate Google. Okay, here we are. First of all, what I need to do here is that change the coordinate system of ModelMuse, of QGIS. So this one is the same as my shape files. In this case, this is my coordinate system. I select and I click OK. Okay, and now they are all in the same coordinate system. Sorry. Okay. So what I'm going to do now, I will deactivate the shape files because this will be the area or the image I want to export and then import into ModelMuse. So I go here to Project and I select Save as Image. And I will export it in this format, and I will give it a name, background, and save it. Now, what I need to do now is open ModelMuse. So here is my ModelMuse. sorry. No, no, sorry, sorry, sorry. I go here to Model Muse and I will create a new model, create new mouth flow model, next. And here in my projection type, I need to indicate the same projection that I'm using in QGIS, which is the one that you can see here in the lower corner, which is 32718. I click next and no grid. Okay, now that I'm here, I go to File, Import, and go to Import Image. Here, I will go to Select Image and choose, oh, this one. Oh, I forgot the D, background. Okay, doesn't matter. And open, and automatically, you will see that the coordinates will appear here. Well, this is very useful because in the case that your image is not like referenced with any system, you will have to do this manually here. So I click OK. And here it is, my background. And now it is georeferenced, as you can see here. And well, now I'm going to import my shapefiles to overlap them, so you can see where they are located. So I go here to File, Import, Shapefile. I will select my study area, for example. Okay. Oops. And here it is. Here is my study area. And now I'm going to import my wells, so I import the shapefile of the wells, open, and okay, oops, and here it is. You can see that both shapefiles are located where they are supposed to be in ModelMuse, so now when you start doing the modeling, it will be easier for you to know where you are located. Now, for example, this is my, since this is my study area, I will show you that in this shapefile, I can assign it to this option that is used to set grid cell size. I will create a grid just to show you. I will leave it with this 1,000 meters of grid cell size just to show you. I click OK, and then I use this Generate Grid tool. Okay, and here it is. And as you can see, the grid is now overlapping the image, and now you can import other shapefiles or create the boundary conditions areas manually over this image directly in ModelMuse. So, this is the end of this tutorial, and I really hope that it has been useful for you. And don't forget to keep on checking Hatari Labs website, because soon we will be releasing an online course of groundwater modeling using ModFlow and ModelMuse. And in this course, you will learn how to build groundwater models and apply several tools that ModelMuse has to offer. It will be a really, really interesting course. So if you like these videos, you will find it very helpful. Also, if you have any questions about this tutorial or any suggestions or another tutorial you would like to see, just contact us via email or through any of our social networks, and we will get in touch with you. So this is it, and until next time, bye-bye.